Welcome to this brief guide on how best to insert charts in PowerPoint. A regular occurrence for many in their daily work lives is to collate data inside Excel and then showcase that in a PowerPoint presentation. A lot of people like to use charts for this. I'm going to show you how best to do this. Today you can see I have my PowerPoint deck currently open and I want to find out who has the best coffee. So I have some survey results that we have here for both Sydney, Melbourne and Adelaide across a few different years. Now what I would normally do with this data is simply highlight all of the data in my table and then I would use quick analysis, which can be accessed using the keyboard shortcut Control plus Q. And this will give me some suggested options for how to format my data or, as you can see here, to insert a chart. Now I could choose maybe something like a clustered chart or potentially even a line chart. I'm going to go with the clustered option here. All I need to do is simply click on that option and there is my chart. Nice and easy. I'm then going to copy this chart just like most people would normally do and then jump back over to PowerPoint and simply use Control V to paste that chart in. Now this is what most people generally do and it's an okay way to do it, but there's a bit of a problem. Say for instance some of the data needs to be edited. Maybe this is some weekly reports that I normally have to do. I can simply right click on my chart and click on the option that says Edit Data in the context menu. The problem that arises here is this then brings me back to Excel, where I can then choose to update my data in the table, and you'll see that my chart is then updated in real time, both inside Excel and over inside my PowerPoint deck as well. Now this is all well and good unless I need to potentially share the PowerPoint deck with someone else, because if I need to do that, I can't really go about sharing both of the files with them all the time. So it'd be really good if I had the ability, instead of needing to share this Excel file as well, I could simply have all of this inside the PowerPoint deck itself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy my table here just so I have a copy of it, and I'm going to remove that chart from PowerPoint. Then we're going to head to the Insert tab in the ribbon, and about a third of the way along we have an option to add a chart. We'll simply select this option and we then need to choose which type of chart we'd like, whether it be that line chart, a pie chart, bar charts, or as we're going to do just like we did before, we're going to have that clustered column chart. So I simply select the clustered column chart and select OK. Now this is going to insert a chart into my PowerPoint deck, and what you'll notice up the top here is I have kind of like a miniature version of Excel directly inside PowerPoint. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace the templated data there with my exact table, and there's our chart all inside PowerPoint ready to go. And one of the key benefits of this particular setup is it means that if I now share this PowerPoint deck with someone else, they don't necessarily need to have the Excel file if they need to edit any of this data later on. They can simply right click on the chart itself, select the option for edit data, and that miniaturized Excel will pop up right there so they can make any changes directly inside PowerPoint and see those changes take effect in real time in the chart as well. This is especially useful for collaboration, but also for instances where you just need to quickly update the data in the chart in order to use it the following time. Now, while we're here, I'll show you one quick bonus feature, and this is actually to do with the Design tab in PowerPoint. You'll notice I have my chart in here at the moment and it's got a particular color scheme. But if I was to change the color scheme of the template, any of the charts that you insert in this manner will automatically update their color schemes to match as well. This is great if you have a particular color scheme that you utilize for your business and you'd love for all of your charts to match. And that is how you best insert a chart in PowerPoint. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video.
Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.